Today, we study the motion of objects in one dimension, that is motion of objects which are moving in a straight path. Man has been fascinated by the observation regarding motion of planets, motion of birds in sky, motion of fishes swimming in water, or any object which moves around us, lots of objects move around us. To have a scientific understanding of these motions of objects, let us begin simply with objects moving in a straight path. Consider an object which moves along a straight path like this. Now, when we say that an object is moving, it means its position must be changing with time. Now, to locate the position with reference to some object or some position, let us say we have the origin, which is represented by O in the figure. Now, the object is at point P, at the location P at a given time t1. The object is at another position Q all along this line at time t2. Then, like this, the object goes on changing its position with respect to time. Then we say change of position continuously with time, we say the object is moving. How do we describe the motion? Motion along a line. One of the things that we do is consider the object at position P, which has the position coordinate x1. What do you mean by position coordinate? The location of the point P with respect to the origin is uniquely represented by the quantity x1 in this direction. Similarly, position of Q is given by its position coordinate, which is x2. When position goes on changing with time, say in the interval from t1 to t2, the object's position has changed from position x1 to x2. Then the change in position, which is represented here as delta x, which represents x2 minus x1, has occurred in a time interval, which is represented by delta t here, which is t2 minus t1. We define a quantity called average velocity for this interval, average velocity as represented by v bar as delta x by delta t. So, the average velocity in the interval t1 to t2 is represented as x2 minus x1 by t2 minus t1. The unit of average velocity is simply meter per second in SI unit. For example, when we say an object is having 4 meter per second as its velocity, what we mean is in every second interval of time, the displacement is 4 meters. Let us represent the motion of this object as position, how position varies with time, position being indicated here. This is x position versus time graph. Now, here we represent its position at point P as its coordinate x1 here time t1 here. Now, point Q has its x coordinate x2 and its time coordinate is t2. Now, the object has moved from point P to point Q. As a function of time, the variation is this. Please understand, when I have joined these points P and Q, I have drawn a graphical representation, not necessarily a straight line. The object is moving in a straight line, but the variation of position with respect to time may be a curve. Now, as here I have represented, The average velocity, how do we represent in the graphical form? You join this point P to Q on the curve by a straight line, as I have done here. Now, in the interval, time interval T1 to T2, which is this interval, the object has changed its position from x1 to x2, which I represent it here as x2 minus x1 represents the change in the position, and in this has occurred in the time interval T2 minus T1. Now, x2 minus x1, we have called it as delta x. Now, in this triangle, the height is represented by delta x. T2 minus T1, which you have called the time elapsed, which is indicated as delta t here, is represented at the base. When we say average velocity, which is represented by v bar, here we mean delta x by delta t. Look at the graph, that is the height of this triangle divided by the base of this triangle, which we call as the slope of this line PQ. Slope of the line PQ represents the average velocity in the interval T1 to T2. Let us look at another graph of the same motion represented by x versus time graph. Here, I have not given the positions, but I have indicated certain time intervals, which is T1, T2. Time interval is the same. Again, T3 and T4 are two different timings, but the time interval T3 and T4, which is given by the interval T3, T4, is the same as delta T here. Also, T5, T6, they are at different positions at different timings. The object has different positions, and in each of these intervals, look at the graph. Say for example, T5, T6, the displacement is indicated by delta x3. In the interval T3 to T4, it is indicated by delta x2 in the graph. It is indicated by the displacement delta x1 is indicated between the interval T1 and T2. In the same time intervals, note from this graph that the time intervals are same, but the displacement in each of these intervals are different. What we mean here is the velocity in the interval T1 to T2, average velocity, which I write it as V1 bar, that is in the interval T1, T2, and average velocity in the interval T2, T3, T4, which I have represented as V2. The average velocity in the interval T5, T6, which I indicated here by V3 bar, each one of them are different because the slopes of these are different. That is, if you take this triangle having the same base, but the heights are different. Heights have gone changing with time. That is, delta x1, delta x2, delta x3 are increasing for the same interval of time, but at different timings. What does it mean is the average velocity goes on changing. So, the position time graph, if it is a curve like this, the average velocity go on changing with time. Then, can we expect, what kind of a graph do we expect for a position time graph of an object which is moving at constant velocity? Can you think? Look at this graph. Let us take same intervals of time at different timings, which I am marking here on the graph. Look at this graph, the delta x in different intervals (3) in the interval T5, T6, T3, T4, look at delta x, which is given by this, represented by the height, which I have indicated delta x2 here. Between T1, T2, the interval is the same, but timings are different. Look at this delta x1. Do you see that in this case, when position time graph x versus t graph is a linear graph, It means the average velocity, that is delta x1 by delta t1, which is the same as delta x2 by delta t2 for the same interval. Delta t1 being equal to delta t2 is also equal to delta t3. In that, delta x3, delta x2 and delta x1, they are all same. So, we say that this is a graph which represents average velocity is same and it is constant, unlike this graph which we did earlier. Look at this. This is a curve where the position time graph had different slopes at different timings. The slopes go on increasing means the velocity goes on increasing. Look at this graph again, where position versus time was a linear graph. We notice that the slope delta x1 by delta t1 is the same as delta x2 by delta t2, is the same as delta x3 and delta t3. The slopes are same, that is the height to base ratio is the same, and this is a straight line. What it means is the velocity does remain constant. Let us review what we have done in terms of how to analyze the motion, whether it is an object is moving at a constant velocity or varying velocity. Let us see, let us look at this graph, position x versus time. If the graph has a variation like this, look at point P. In the interval around this, the slopes, that is delta x by delta t, is positive. Look at this interval where delta x variation is not there. There is a variation of delta t during the same interval. What does it mean? When there is no variation, the height is 0. So, it means this is the position. In this time interval, the average velocity is 0. Let us look at this position again, where if I take the same interval, delta t represented being same, but at different timings, the slope is different. It means in this kind of a nonlinear variation of x versus t, we come to the conclusion that average velocity goes on changing with time. Now, we are talking only about average velocity. That is, when you say an object is between, example, if you say that an object is having an average velocity of 4 kilometer per hour or 40 kilometer per hour, whatever it is, when we say, you should specify the interval over which the average velocity is there. Otherwise, it has no meaning. What do you mean by when we say the car is moving at 40 kilometers per hour? How can car move at a certain instant of time? How can it have a velocity? We have said, when we talked about average velocity, we said there is a certain interval of time where we measure the change in position and the time interval over which, and we said average velocity is defined over an interval of time. What do you mean by instantaneous velocity? Look at this position time graph again, x versus t. The object is at a point P at a certain interval, and let us indicate it as x1 as the position coordinate at time t1. What do we mean by at point P, what is its velocity? Or what is its velocity at time t1? What do we mean by this? Now, how do we determine this? Does it make any sense at all? Let us look at the variation of this position coordinate of this object, which has been given like this. Now, when we say the velocity at average velocity, let us try to find out the average velocity. How do you find out the average velocity? Let us take a certain interval of time, say a time before this and a time little afterwards. Let us call this as a small interval of time, and if we indicate it here, that is t1 minus a certain amount of time and t1 plus certain amount of time. Now, here I find out what is called as change in position in that small interval of time, which I represent it as delta x and call it as delta x by delta t, but please note this t, delta t is smaller. You make it still smaller. Around this point, take two points very close by, make this very small, that is delta t in this case, delta x, again you find out delta t t, but this delta t being smaller than the earlier one. Go on doing this. Now, what we mean by instantaneous velocity at a certain time, which is represented by v, we mean delta x by delta t for small intervals of time when which we indicate delta t tending to 0. We are trying to find out the value of delta x by delta t when delta t tends to 0. And in the graph, if this is the slope, then you make the interval smaller and smaller, then you draw a line and it becomes a tangent, and the slope of the tangent is what we mean by v instantaneous velocity. Slope of a tangent drawn to the curve at point P, but whatever be the point, that gives the instantaneous velocity. So, what we have done today is to define average velocity as velocity in an interval of time, that is change in this position coordinate, which we have called it as displacement. Displacement over an interval of time, time rate of change of displacement, that is delta x variation with delta t. Delta x by delta t, we have called it as average velocity. What is instantaneous velocity? Instantaneous velocity is average velocity over a very, very small interval of time, which we call it as instantaneous velocity. The average velocity and instantaneous velocity are two different things. Average velocity is over an interval of time, whereas an instantaneous velocity is at a certain instant of time, which is found by drawing the slope of a tangent at a given point. Whereas, average velocity is measured by finding out the slope of the chord or the secant that is drawn between two points. In the next class, we will see how variation of velocity with time is to be understood in terms of a quantity called acceleration.